when I travel, I eat all organic, and it messes with my system when I travel, and I can't eat all those chemicals. And so grocery stores are so different. And so I never even thought of, you know, calling a manager and saying, okay, do you have this brand that I eat or this brand? That's some good. I do pack a lot of my food though, because I do have a free bag on American Airlines. So I'm like, oh yeah, I'm taking advantage of that. And so, another suggestion, if you're traveling and you are flying, if you get whatever their, you know, usually it's the airline's credit card, you get a free bag. So it's a good way. You don't even have to use the card. I think we used it pay for my son's college tuition and paid it off. And then we had hit our points and we went, oh good, let's just put it in the drawer. I get a free bag every time I travel because I have a card. So
that would be helpful.
It's kind of a no-brainer, because otherwise it's, you pay for the baggage fee there and the baggage fee back, and that gets to be expensive. So
money
saving tip for you.
Yes. And with the grocery stores, I've even helped. Like, we had Thanksgiving at my aunt's house for the first time ever. And because I've always just, we've had to eat at home, it's the only way that it felt safe. And she offered to host Thanksgiving this year and was open to accommodating the kids' allergies, even though I don't allow my children to eat food that other people have prepared. The environment still had to be safe in order for them to be there, because if food was being cooked, then the proteins could be aerosolized. And then if it was on people's hands, then it would be cross-contaminated around the house. And especially with a four-year-old that I can only keep under wraps so much.
Exactly. I mean, normal four-year-olds are picking cookies off the, you know, the platters, and, you know,
Oh my gosh, rolling on the floor, licking the floor. Never know what the four-year-old was. And so for that, she came up, well, she called first and we went over the allergies again for the kids. And then I told her to come up with a list of what she wanted to make. I was like, you do your wish list without necessarily thinking about the allergies. Right. And then any recipe that contained an allergen, she would text me, and then I would text her what was the substitute. So if it called for cream cheese, I would go in my refrigerator and take a picture of the cream cheese. And then I would tell her what grocery store was found out to make it easier on her.
Right.
And then for family who was traveling from out of town, who was coming in, I knew their address. So I called the manufacturer and then gave them my other aunt's address. And then they were able to tell me the nearest grocery store to where she was to help her find the items. So if they were willing to accommodate, then I just wanted to make it as easy and as streamlined for them. It was pretty funny because there were a few things that they thought, like, they could just run out to the store and buy. And I just laughed. Like, not in my world. This special order, like, a week in advance, directly from the manufacturer. So it was fun. Like, it was, like, I think it might have been a little bit frustrating, but it was kind of to be kind of funny at the end that they started to realize how hard it was to find the things. But on the flip side, how doable it was. It's possible to do it. We had a fantastic, massive family dinner, and nobody starved and nobody complained. Everybody enjoyed the food, and we were able to focus on what we were there for, which was to spend time together and not have to worry about the safety of the kids. So.
Definitely. Yeah, that's how we did Christmas last year. We were talking about this before the broadcast started, and we've got so many food allergies in our family, and went to the grocery store and went through every packaging, every list, because they were all from out of town, and said that this is a grocery store I normally go to, but of course I don't have those allergies in my house, so I, you know, kind of guided them through there. Did good.
Yeah, and they don't put all the information on the labels of food. They're only required by law to label what's in the ingredients. So if people's allergies, or even if their intolerances, are so severe that they can't do food that is made on shared equipment or in the same facility as something that they're avoiding, then you must call the manufacturer, because that is not required. That's a voluntary statement. That is not required or regulated in any way by the FDA.
And we had talked about this earlier too, is even packaging includes a lot of allergens. And so aware of the packaging even. And so that's why you look for a specific brand.
Yes.
Because you know that brand has this packaging. And it's not because, oh, we're just picky eaters. No.
No. It's usually at least three times as much as an alternative. And so, no, we would choose the cheaper option if we could, but rarely can we. Yeah.